how many have come to other meetings? So we still have quite a few new people. That's great. Can I ask those who are the newcomers if you would stand, please? Thank you. And now I'm going to ask everybody to stand, and I'm going to ask the newcomers if they would lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Scott Dahl, Steve Rodia. in attendance, Toll Brothers, Andrew Seaman, who's the division president, and Dave Abbott, who did the fiscal analysis for Toll Brothers.
Also, Russ did not mean to forget, and Chris Patriarca, who would be very happy to have his name not mentioned because that's who you send all your emails to. He's our Westtown planning director. The mandate of the Planning Commission is to determine how or whether this submission is consistent with the 2001 Township Growth Management and Comprehensive Plan, the Westtown Open Space Parks and Recreation Plan, and the physical development of the township. The PC will make recommendations, including conditions, that will be submitted to the Board of Supervisors as part of the supervisor's mandate of an ongoing conditional use hearing. That first hearing will take place February 22nd. The Planning Commission has had afforded all the resources that that we requested. We've heard from Westtown residents, we've heard from non-Westtown residents. We've heard from other Westtown commissions, historic, parks, and recreation. We've heard from planning consultants on both sides, civil engineers on both sides, sewer consultants, traffic and transportation consultants reports, police and fire, fiscal impact analysis, historical consultants from Brandywine Battlefield, and the Chester County Planning Commission.
Okay, so we'd like to go over a quick summary of what we accomplished in the previous meetings. For those of you who are new, this is your first meeting. You'll find, I hope, some information here. Again, all the summary slides of the presentations, minutes of the presentations are all available on the township's website. October 19th, last year, we received the application of the township. And then on November 16th, the Planning Commission held its first public meeting. The Planning Commission explained what the process was. Andrew Seaman of Toll Brothers presented their development plan for Great Valley. And then the public and the Planning Commission was invited to ask questions directly of Toll.
At the second public meeting, which was December 15th, the Planning Commission and you heard from Sean Moore of the Western Heritage Mapping Organization, who presented an interactive map showing the Brandywine Battlefield or Battle of Crib Village. Dave Walters, the chairman at the time of the Westtown Historic Commission, made a presentation on some of the historic buildings located on Crivelli, and John Snook of the Brandywine Conservancy, who's our planning consultant, made a presentation on the possible land use and conservancy that might be utilized at Crivelli.
On January 10th of this year, it was our third public meeting. Bill Mallon.
Oh, okay, stop a minute. Can we do something? Patriarca needs an ovation. We got it. It's not snowing outside. It's okay.
Thank you for your pity.
Bill Mallon of Carroll Engineering discussed the possible sewer alternatives and related issues to the drip irrigation proposed by the applicant. Al Federico and Kimley Horn discussed the traffic issues, such as the intersection of 202 and 926 and New Street and 926. He presented his thoughts on traffic flow in and around the development in such areas as the Connector Road and internal vehicle movement.
On January 24, 2017, at the most recent meeting, our fourth, John Snook, our planning consultant, provided a view of Crivelli Farm after it has been developed with an animated video flyover. Kevin Matson and McCormick Taylor, our engineering consultant, presented his comments on some of the engineering and stormwater issues. And Kristen Camp, the Planning Commission solicitor, who's right here, discussed the issue of party status for the upcoming conditional use hearing of the Board of Supervisors.
Okay, and then our fifth public meeting, we're gonna do a quick review of fiscal impact analysis And then we're going to begin the process as Dick laid out, of going through the recommendations that we will eventually present to the Board of Supervisors.
And as we've done in each of the meetings, I'm going to ask and invite each of the Planning Commission members to express if they wish to, whatever is on their mind coming into this meeting, before we move on to the core of the meeting. So we'll start with Brent.
I would just like to thank all the consultants who have prepared a number of reports for us, and Kristen, who's done a fantastic job of preparing the background information about the township's own ordinances so that everything is right in front of us when we need it. Thank you.
I'll echo Brent's thanks to the consultants and Kristen. And also comment that in all my years of working with Westtown Township, I've never seen any project bring out as many residents consistently to follow it. And it is, as our chairman said on occasion, nice to have an audience and to know that you are interested.
I would like to echo what the folks have said, and in addition, I would like to invite you to please continue to come to our meetings on a regular basis. Not all of you, but enough to fill up. Thank you.
So again, I've complimented everyone who have been at the prior meetings on staying the course. Again, we're a recommending or advisory body, and we'll do our job. We'll recommend and advise. The hearings start on the 22nd, so again, the conditional use hearings are as important or more important than the work we've done today. I also want to just take 1 minute and express to all of you, so you know some of the inside baseball here, the chairman, Dick Pomerantz, and vice chairman, Russ Hatton, in conjunction with Chris, the amount of work that they've put in advance of each of these meetings, and since July, as Jim just whispered in my ear, it truly is incredible. It takes a special kind of person to do and put in that kind of effort for what is essentially a volunteer position for the community that you live in and care about. So I just extend
be here, and I'll add my thanks as well to Dick for his leadership in this whole process. He's quite a bulldog when it needs to get something done as far as his planning. I am so glad to have this meeting and move on to the next phase of this process. I also hope that the applicant listens to these recommendations, takes them as what they're intended, as ways to make this development, if there is a development, the best that it can be for Westtown. Thank you.
Kristen, you want to say something?
advance to truly look out for the interests of the community. So kudos to all of you. And to the applicant as well for allowing this process to occur.
A few thoughts and comments on my part. First, I want to thank my colleagues on the Planning Commission for their forbearance, diligence, preparation, attention to detail. Most important, the confidentiality by which you have conducted yourselves and overall professionalism, how you carried out this process in what frankly is a once-in-a-lifetime Planning Commissioner process. It hasn't been easy, with the obvious backdrop of emotion that most of all, not all of you understand, that surrounds this application for this property by this developer, with at least 1,000 pages to review and lots of things to consider. Second, gratitude to our solicitor, Kristen, all of the consultants, the township's planning director. And third, a thank you for the small working group of PC members, my partner on this initiative, Russ Hatton, our newest PC member, Scott Yaw, who may have viewed himself starting out as a rookie, but whose insightful contributions through our many meetings by conference call and in person with our solicitor and consultants belied any rookie concern. And finally, a huge thank you to you, the residents and non-residents of Westtown, for your attention and for your passionate yet courteous decorum during these meetings. In my opening statement months ago, and reiterated again several more times, I genuinely wish we had never had to be here doing what we are doing for the future of Cabilly Farm, for what I characterize then and now as the iconic centerpiece of Westtown Township. I wish history could have been rewritten over at least two decades with a board of supervisors throughout with greater foresight, more thoughtful care and concern, and a deeper understanding that when you ignore or do nothing to preserve your past, you've compromised your future. It didn't have to be this way. Some view a conservation fund, had they done so early on, as other townships have done, to buy outright or at least buy down part of Cabilly as some kind of onerous tax. I don't. Investing to save part or all of your legacy is a collective gift for the generations to come. Which brings me to one other thought. I just wish at least once Toll Brothers had not dismissed out of hand that in no way would they consider even a partial buy down of Cabilly when they were asked directly by you, if the monies to do so could be put together. For Toll, they would have had to be compensated at full market value, thereby reducing the risk that all of their houses might not sell. Being a public company, Toll's number one commitment has to be to their shareholders. I get that. I've had clients in this industry. But full market value compensation would in no way have negatively impacted their shareholders. So that leads me to believe there may be something else at play here. Perhaps a landowner, justifiably angry and frustrated by their first submission for a large, elegant, continuing care retirement community, which actually was approved by Westtown, but it fell through by the wayside due to no fault of anyone but by the market crash. And then the township's board of supervisors a couple of years ago, unable to agree after months of dickering on a much more limited apartment complex that would have encompassed something like 19 acres. So maybe the landowner has decided that it's time to dig in their heels to dictate to Toll that there will be no consideration of anything other than 317 or 319 houses at a minimum. Obviously, none of us know what the truth is, but a truism is that without a willing landowner, no partial or full preservation of Cabilly will happen. Which brings me finally to a hope and a prayer that if and when the Board of Supervisors and Toll have come to agreement, and Toll becomes eventually the full de facto and de jure owner of Cabilly, that Toll senior management will see the light and realize that the aesthetic appeal and financial value of their housing development will be that much more enhanced, not by them maximizing the number of houses, but rather by a lesser number of houses surrounded by as much preserved land as possible. That way everyone wins. Toll, its stakeholders, its shareholders, the home buyers, the township, nature, and everyone for whom Cabilly is not just another piece of property. Thank you. now I turn to my colleagues at the PC. We've all had a chance to read the fiscal impact that was done by our consultant and the fiscal impact study that was done by the consultant for Toll. And just for the record, does anybody have some questions or comments so that we can chronicle those, and that'll be part of our record to be submitted to the board. Let's start with anybody, any comments at all?
So the four award planning impact study analysis done by Todd Poole, it essentially speaks for itself, and I know at a point we'll have it up on the website. Is that right, Chris?
Yes, it'll be up.
The one thing I would point out, based on the analysis that Mr. Poole used, particularly with respect to breaking out the public school children and by grade, the Rutgers study that he relied on breaks